Hello everybody! Today I'm gonna show how to use the JWT, the JSON Web Token, to authenticate requests in a Spring Boot application. This video comes together with a playlist where I'm building a complete website with Spring Boot step by step. If you're ready to know why the JWT is so useful against the other authentication systems, take a seat, remember to subscribe to my channel, and let's go! I will start from this project that you can find in GitHub, in a link in the video's description. I've already configured the course, where I've configured the allowed headers and the HTTP methods. Let's go now with the security stuff. I will start with the Maven dependency. And now in the security configuration, I will need the following. An entry point to handle the authentication exceptions. This is not mandatory, but I prefer to return a proper message than a stack trace. An HTTP filter dedicated to handle the regular authentication, the login and password authentication. An HTTP filter dedicated to handle the authentication with JWT. Indicate that the session will never be created as I am in a stateless application, which endpoints doesn't require the authentication and the remaining will require the authentication. And I will create and a component, a provider, which will validate the token and communicate with the authentication service to validate the login and password. Let's create those classes. Why handle the authentication via HTTP filters? This way, the authentication is not present in the code, in the controllers. The HTTP filters will be executed before reaching the controllers. For the username password authentication, I could have done in the controller. But for the authentication based on a token, I must always pass through a process to validate the request is authenticated. The token must be sent in all the requests done by the frontend. It will be sent in a header. So before reaching a controller where it's asking for some personal content, I must ensure that the request has the authentication information in the headers. If yes, let's continue the request until the controller. and if it's not correctly authenticated, return an exception. Okay then, why to use an HTTP filter for the username password authentication? This way, I have a single way to authenticate a user via the HTTP filters. I don't have the logic split in several services. But the best advantage is the following. This annotation authentication principle will inject the object of the authenticated user in my controller. Using the HTTP filters, I set into the security context the user information, the user object. And Spring, with this annotation, will look for the user object in the security context. This way, having the user authenticated with any system type, JWT or password, I will always have the user object injected in my controllers. Let's go now with the filter dedicated to handle the regular authentication, the authentication via username and password. This filter will be only used in the signed-in endpoint. I will read the credentials information in the request. And then validate the credentials with the authentication service provider. This service must return me some authentication object. And if some error occurs, I clear the security context. And don't forget to call the filter at the end of the method. Let's go now with the more interesting filter, the JWT filter. The token must come in the authorization header. The first part of the header must be the bearer information, and then call the authentication service provider to validate the token. As before, this must return me some authentication object to fill the security context. And as before, clear the security context if some error occurs. Before going to the authentication provider service, let's quickly see what the entry point contains, the entry point which handles the authentication exceptions. This component will only return a custom error message instead of the stack trace. and now the expected service provider, where the JWT is built and validated, and where the username password is also validated. This secret key is used to build the JWT. I encode it in Base64 to avoid having it visibly available in the JVM. Let's now create the JWT token. The JWT is divided in three parts. The header, which contains the information about the algorithm used to cipher the token and what kind of token it is. Then comes the payload with the claims. The claims are some standard information you can find in the token, as the username, the expiration time, the creation date and more. And I can have some custom claims. And the last part is the signature. For the signature, I use the header content, encoded it in Base64, I then use the payload content, also encoded in Base64, and encrypt the concatenation of both using the algorithm specified in the header. The resulting token will be the header encoded in Base64, followed by a dot, the payload encoded in Base64, followed by a dot, and the signature. Hopefully, I have a library to perform those actions for me. Let's now build the JWT. And to validate the token, I already have a parse method which does it. If some information is incorrect or the expiration date is in the past, an exception will be thrown. and I will return this object, which will be used in the security context to allow Spring inject the user information in the controller with the already seen annotation. And finally, the authentication for the username and password. A quick recap of what I've done. I created the security configuration which defines the order of the HTTP filters, the exception handler with the entry point, the endpoints which don't need authentication, and the session management. I've created two HTTP filters, one for the username password authentication and the other for JWT. I've created the entry point to handle the authentication exceptions and return a custom response. I've created a service provider which builds the JWT, validates it, and validates the password. And finally, if the request is correctly authenticated, add the user information in the security context to have it available in the controllers via the annotation. Saturated, let's see how it works. Here I have my JWT, the three parts, the first one with the header, the second one with the payload, and the third one with the signature. Let's now use it. Easy to use, right? That's the main point. It's easy to use, and it can be used for simple applications or for complicated applications which have some SSO, where I must authenticate in one system to use it in the second system. It's a secure and fast authentication system. I hope you enjoyed the video. If that's the case, click on the like button and remember to subscribe to my channel, because it's the best way to help me and encourage me to do more videos like this one. And see you in the next video. Bye!